we are dealing with second unit, that is sound of music, and this unit has been divided into two part. First part, the life of Iblian we have done. Secondly, we have started the life of Bismillah Khan. Up to 7th paragraph we have done. So today that later part will be discussed. So on page number 23 I am here and reading that paragraph number 8. Bismillah Khan has given many memorable performances both in India and abroad. So in last paragraph we discussed that he got his first break in All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938, and after that he became famous. And another chance which he has just got is he was the first Indian who just Greek nation when we got our independence, that is on 15th August 1947. And he greeted nation by playing his Shehnai. So this way Bismillah Khan became famous. Paragraph number 8, now what happened here? That after this he just started giving all the performance in India and abroad even. His first trip abroad was to Afghanistan, where King Zahir Shah was so taken in by the maestro that he gifted him priceless Persian carpet and other souvenirs. Now what happened? His first abroad performance was there in Afghanistan. And when he was there in Afghanistan for Shehnai playing, that king of Afghanistan, the name of that king is King Zahir Shah. He was so attracted, he was so just charmed, or we can say fascinated by Bismillah Khan's performance, that he had given Bismillah Khan a priceless, expensive Persian carpet and many other gifts he has given to Bismillah Khan. Here we got three new words, that is taken in, it means attracted or charmed by. Secondly, it is maestro, it means master. Thirdly, it is souvenirs, it means things given in memory of a place, person or event. So this day, this king of Afghanistan, that is King Zahir Shah, has given these things to Bismillah Khan. The king of Afghanistan was not the only one to be fascinated by Bismillah's music. Film director Vijay Bhatt was so impressed after hearing Bismillah's play at festival that he named a film after the instrument called Gunjuti Shehnai. It was not only that the king of Afghanistan who was impressed by Bismillah Khan, but the music and film director, that is Vijay Bhatt, he was also impressed with Bismillah Khan's performance, that he had given the, that Shehnai word. He has used the Shehnai word in one of his film titles, that is Gunjuti Shehnai. So there is a movie like Gunjuti Shehnai in Bollywood. Vijay Bhatt has directed that. Film was hit. That film was so hit, super hit we can say. And one of Bismillah Khan's composition, Dil Ka Khilona Hai Toot Gaya. There is a song named Dil Ka Khilona Hai Toot Gaya, and that was composed by Bismillah Khan, and that song was super hit. Turned out to be national wide chartbuster. Chartbuster means record buster. Here it is written, chartbuster word means record breaker. So that song just has broken all the records. Despite this huge success in celluloid world, Bismillah Khan's ventures in film music were limited to two. Though he was so famous, he was so successful in Bollywood, but then even he didn't get much film, many films or many chances to compose songs and music into film. He had only two films in his favor in Bollywood. So here we got this word celluloid, means old fashioned way of referring to film, and venture means project that often involves risk. Bismillah Khan's ventures in film music were limited to two: Vijay Bhatt's Gunjuti Shehnai and Vikram Srinivas' Kannad venture Sanadi Appanna. So these two films, there are two films in which Bismillah Khan has composed music, that is Gunjuti Shehnai, and one Kannad venture, that is Sanadi Appanna. I just can't come to terms with the artificiality and glamour of the film world, he says with emphasis. He was so much, we can say, sad that he told one thing that he was so much sad about the artificiality of the glamour of this Bollywood, in this film city or this film world, because there was you can find only artificiality in this field, in this film field. While on the other hand, Bismillah Khan was believing in reality. That's why he wasn't fit there in that film industry. Paragraph number 9, I am reading, student. Awards and recognition came thick and fast. Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to be invited to perform at the prestigious Lincoln Central Hall in the United States of America. Another thing which it is that figure of Bismillah Khan's cap, we can say. He got chance and he was invited to perform at the prestigious Lincoln Central Hall in United States of America. He also took part in the World Exposition in Montreal in the Cannes Art Festival and in the Osaka Trade Fair. Apart from that, Lincoln Central Hall, he had also taken part in World Exposition in Montreal and in Cannes Art Festival and another there in the Osaka Trade Fair. So it was, we can say, a pride moment, a proud moment for Bismillah Khan or for our Indian that he got this much chances to take part in international fair. So well known did he become internationally that an auditorium in Tehran was named after him, Tahar Mosiki Ustad Bismillah Khan. So he was so famous in international stage. So what happened in Tehran, one of auditorium, those people have given name of Bismillah Khan to that auditorium. And what was the name of that? It was Tahar Mosiki Ustad Bismillah Khan. So it was really indeed an honorable thing for any Indian. Paragraph number 10, I am reading, student. National awards like the Padma Shri, the Padma Bhushan and the Padma Vibhushan were conferred on him. Conferred means given usefully an award or degree. So when you take award or degree at that time, this conferred word is used instead of give. So this kind of prestigious awards were there in the favor of Bismillah Khan. National awards like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan were conferred on him. Means he got this kind of honorable national awards. Paragraph number 11, student. In 2001, Ustad Bismillah Khan was awarded India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. You all know that Bharat Ratna is the highest civilian award of India. So, in 2001, recently we can say that Ustad Bismillah Khan has received that highest civilian award, that is Bharat Ratna, with the coveted award resting on his chest and his eyes glinting with rare happiness. All I would like to say is, teach your children music. This is Hindustan's richest tradition. Even the West is now coming to learn our music. So when he was conferred this Bharat Ratna, at that time he was so happy. His eyes were gleaming with happiness, glinting with happiness, and that coveted award means that much desired, means he was the deserving, the most deserving candidate for Bharat Ratna. So when he was getting this award, at that time he had given that speech, and in his speech he told that, teach your children music. Means he requested all the parents or all the people of India that every children should be taught music, as the music is Hindustan's richest tradition. And he again further he told that now internationally foreigners, or we can say West people, is also coming to learn that classical music of India. So classical music of India is so popular in country, western country. So those people were coming here to learn that classical music. That's why this Nilla Khan has advised all the parents to teach their children music, as it is our Hindustan's culture. Paragraph, here we got one word, that is kapoted. Students, before that you have some time to note down these words. Please note down this.
He was traveling in a foreign country at that time.
he was yearning for Hindustan. He was yearning means he was continuously thinking about Hindustan. And while I am in foreign country, I keep yearning to see Hindustan. While in Mumbai, I think of only Banaras and Holy Ganga. And he told that when he was in Mumbai, he was thinking about River Ganga and Banaras. And while he was in Banaras, I missed the unique Matha of Dhamrao. And he added that while he was in Banaras, at that time he was missing that unique Matha of Dhamrao. On page number 25, I am reading, student. So here we have given one interview of Bismillah Khan. The small letters suggest interview. Shekhar Gupta has taken interview of Bismillah Khan, and here Shekhar Gupta asked, when partition happened, didn't you and your family think of moving to Pakistan? So here Shekhar Gupta asked Bismillah Khan, when partition happened, why didn't Bismillah Khan and his family move to Pakistan? Bismillah Khan told, God forbid me leave Banaras, never. I went to Pakistan once. I crossed the border just to say I have been to Pakistan. I was there for about an hour. I said namaskar to the Pakistanis and salam alaikum to the Indians. I had a good laugh. So he told that no, I would never leave Hindustan. Thinking about to leave Hindustan will not be possible in his life. He also added that when he had visited Pakistan, at that time he just crossed that border just to say I have been to Pakistan. Means for the sake of saying that he had been in Pakistan, he just had crossed that border of Pakistan. When he was there in Pakistan, at that time he called namaste to Pakistanis and salam alaikum to Hindustanis. This way he just started laughing. Ustad Bismillah Khan's life is a perfect example of rich cultural heritage of India. You will find the glimpse of cultural heritage of India in Ustad Bismillah Khan's life. One that effortlessly accepts that a devout Muslim like him can very naturally play the Shehnai every morning at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. Here we got one word, student, that is devout. And devout means believing.
Sadness and sorrow.
government of India declared one day national mourning and that Bismillah Khan was given a state funeral, which was honorable thing for any Indian. So here we have ended this unit, student. Here we got very beautiful information about Bismillah Khan and his life, how he started playing Shehnai and how he became the indispensable part of film industry and India, how he got the civilian awards of India and how he died, and his great interest for Banaras and River Ganga. Those information we have given from his unit of Bismillah Khan. Now it's time to give you homework, student. Your today's homework is, but before you have some time to note down these new words, please note down this. Write these 15 new words in your book. Student, here we have completed our two unit. Unit number 1 and 2. While second unit has divided into two parts. So we will meet again in next video. Till then, please take care of yourself, student. Bye.